यशोवे नापसी यावे रोई लो इक्सा बीनो देसे यार बेसे नी अलमेओ मेनु को यनाय लेनी नापसी यशोवे नापसी यान खानी व मागलव सदा Yan kani wa magalev sede, yan kani wa magalev sede, yan kani wa magalev sede, leman shemo napsi yeshove napsi yave roi lo iksa. Veroi lo iksa bino desi arbese ni almeo menu kot yanai leni napsi yeshove napsi yan kani wa magalev sede yan kani wa magalev sede Yan kani we magalev sede, yan kani we magalev sede, leman shemo napsi yeshove napsi. Actually, in modern Hebrew, they sing Adonai, Adonai instead of Yahweh, they sing Adonai. But we know the name of our Lord. That is Yahweh. So instead of that Adonai, we can say Yahweh. Yahweh Roi. Roi means he is my shepherd. Roi means he is my closest friend. And Roi, another translation of Roi, he is your lover. So there are three meanings of Roi. One is shepherding. One, he is your lover and he is your closest friend. Rea, the root word is Rea. That means he is a closest friend. So when Psalmist is saying Yahweh Roi, so he is saying Yahweh is my not only my shepherd, but he is my closest friend and he loves me. So Yahweh Roi Lo Exar. Lo means not. Exar means not lack. I will not lack in any of the good things. Yahweh Roi Lo Exar Bin Odese Yarveseni. So he leads me into the pastures green and almeo menu kot yanai leni. So alme means on still waters. Yanai leni means he leads me in the paths of righteousness for his namesake. So during the course of time, you will also learn this song. For now, you can watch YouTube video on Psalm 23. In Hebrew. Okay. We'll begin the session. I request Pastor Monica to open the session with prayer. I will just unmute you. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, you can unmute now.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Such a beautiful beginning. Shepherd, closest friend, lover. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for such a beautiful divine time, Lord. And we are so blessed to be in your holy presence. And we all, first of all, thank you, Lord, for giving us, for blessing us with this such a huge blessing of learning Hebrew. We all come together in one accord and we all bless the beautiful, humble heart of Brother Rahul that he decided to teach your holy language so we can all learn you even more, know you even more closer, Lord Jesus. Lord, I bless every every participant in this class, Lord, that you, it's your Holy Spirit who's going to lead us, who's going to guide us, who's going to help us to learn this holy language. We cannot do it from human understanding, but from your might, your will. We all surrender ourselves, and Lord, we are ready to receive those most precious words from your heaven again today. Lord, lead us so we can learn this faster. We can read, write, speak it, Lord, and for your glory, Lord. Thank you, Father. We once again surrender at your holy feet. And Lord, we pray that your Holy Spirit is going to lead this meeting through Brother Rahul. And we are going to receive today's portion of our blessing in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
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 Thank you so much, Brother Rahul. God bless you.
Thank you. Toda. Shalom Aleichem. I'm not hearing any responses. Shalom Aleichem.
Shalom Aleichem.
You have to say Aleichem.
Aleichem Shalom.
Aleichem Shalom.
Aleichem Shalom. Shalom Aleichem. You have to say Aleichem. Shalom Aleichem, I will say. And you have to say Aleichem Shalom. Okay. Shalom Aleichem.
Aleichem Shalom.
Ma Shalem Ka.
Ma Shalem Ka.
You can give me three responses. First is Toh. Then second, Meur Toh. Or Lora.
Lora.
It's not bad. So again, I'm asking you. Ma Shalem Ka.
Tora.
Or Ma Shalem Mek.
Lora.
Lora.
Hearing Lora. Some Loras. Okay. At the end of the session, that will be turned to Meurto. One more session. This session we're going to spend on alphabets, and from next session we're going to start vowel. In vowel we are going to see this, as in English we see a e I o u type of vowel. So here in Hebrew also we are going to see this short vowel and long vowel. So next time, next session will be on vowel. So this session will be on the alphabet. So that you may get very familiar with the alphabet. Let's begin from the Aleph. Repeat after me. Aleph.
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 Aleph. I request everyone to participate. Beth.
Aleph.
Beth.
Aleph.
Beth.
Aleph. Beth.
Gimel.
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 Dalet.
Dalet.
Hey.
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 Wow.
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 Zain.
Zain.
Keth.
Keth.
Remember that this Keth is a guttural letter and it should come out of the throat. It is a strong guttural letter. See this he and keth are a strong guttural letter. If you put your hand on throat, you'll see the vibration that coming from your throat. That is yeah. Keth. Hey, and Keth are strong gutturals, whereas Aleph and Ain are a big guttural. Teth.
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 Yod.
Yod.
Kaf.
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 Lamed.
Lamed.
Mem.
Mem.
Now you see, when you are speaking mem, your lips are moving. That's why this mem is called label. It is called label letter. Because your two lips are moving when you pronounce mem. When you this bet also bet when you pronounce bet, bet. It is bet. Also label letter.
Label.
Noon.
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 Stomach.
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 Ein.
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 Some people are not serious. They are putting so many background noise and too disturbing. So this ein in the ancient time. This ein and aleph are a weak guttural, but this ein actually in ancient time it gives a G sound, and the letter that the word that is Gamora is derived, the first letter used is ein. It sometimes gives a guttural G sound, that is Gamora. Gamora.
Gamora.
Gamora.
And remember one thing, Gamora. That aleph and ein both are the silent letter. English transliteration of aleph is apostrophe and ein is reverse apostrophe. If you put vowel marking under this aleph and ein, then they follow the vowel which, suppose A class is vowel is there, so they will produce A class sound. If it is E class vowel, they will produce E class vowel. Whichever vowel we put under it, they will produce that kind of sound. Then pay.
Pay.
Pay. Pay.
Pay.
Sade.
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 Sade. Sade.
Sade.
Kuf.
Fresh.
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 Remember that sound of resh is very different. Not clear R, but it is resh.
Resh.
Resh. So your tongue goes up when you are pronouncing this resh.
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 Then sheen and sheen.
Sheen
and sheen.
And sheen.
Sheen.
And last alphabet is tau.
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 Tau. Tau. Tau.
Yeah. Remember that if we put dagesh in beth, then it is clear B. Without dagesh, it is vet. Similarly, there is no distinguishing sound between this gimel dalet, but there is in ancient time a little distinguishing sound. So when we learn syllabification, then you'll understand what that sound is. If you are if you know Hindi and or in Marathi, so there is a little different sound between g, that is gimel g, and gh. For dalet, it is d, clear d if there is dagesh, and without dagesh, it is like d. Similarly, there is different, but it is distinguishing sound, kaap and ka. Kaap, that is clear k. With dagesh, and without dagesh, it is khfaf, ka. Like in Hindi or Marathi, k and kh. Then this pay, it is distinguishing sound, pay and pay, or p, clear p when dagesh is there, and ph sound in phone when there is no dagesh. So seen and sheen, you know. And also tau, it is clear T when there is dagesh, that is dot. And when there is no dagesh, then the sound is in between T and TH, like in Hindi and Marathi, th. It is clear t, and if there is a, no dagesh, then it is th. Th. Okay. Aleph, English transliteration is apostrophe. It is a silent letter. Then say after me, Beth and Veth.
Beth and Veth.
Then Gimel and Gimel.
Gimel.
Although in English transliteration there is no differentiation sound, it is G in dot only. Yeah. Then Dalit and Dalit.
Dalit and Dalit.
See, when there is a dagesh, that is dot, it is clear, clear Dalit. Clear Dalit. Don't misunderstand.
Dalit.
Clear Dalit.
Dalit.
Clear.
Without dagesh dot, it is like DH sound, Dalit.
Dalit. Dalit.
But in English transliteration, it is clear D only.
Dalit.
Then hey.
Hey.
Hey, hey gives ho sound. That is H in hot. Ho. Ho sound.
Hot.
Let's deal with this five alphabets. Say after me, Aleph, silent letter.
Aleph, silent letter.
Silent.
Then Beth will give B, B sound.
Beth.
Beth.
B.
Beth.
Bet. And with w.
Bet.
W.
W.
Yeah. Bet b in English translation b in bat and v in vat. Then gimel it gives g. G sound.
Gimel.
G in got.
G.
Then Dalit, it will give a D sound. D.
Yeah.
D. Dalit.
E in Dalit. Dot.
Dot.
Then He, it gives H. H in hot.
He, H.
He.
H in hot. Then Wow.
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 Classical biblical Hebrew, it will not give V sound. Not V. Because we already have Beth Veth. Veth gives clear V sound, not W sound. So if you are watching some videos from modern Hebrew, some video that, so you'll be getting very confused. So be very careful to watch only biblical Hebrew, that is classical biblical Hebrew videos. So wow, in biblical Hebrew it gives a W sound. W,
uh-huh.
Not V. Then Zayin.
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 It gives Z sound.
Zayin.
Zion. Zion. Like Zion. Yeah, Zion.
Then next alphabet is Keth.
Keth.
Keth is a very strong guttural.
Keth.
It gives K sound in Bak.
Bak.
Bak. Not S sound, K. K sound.
Bak.
And watch the transliteration in your assignments and in the exam also. There are some example when you have to write the English transliteration. So Keth is under H, there is dot. Whereas Hey, only H is a transliteration. Then Teth. Say after me. Teth.
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 Because tau is having clear T sound, so English transliteration, it is under T, there is a dot. to distinguish between this transliteration, under T there is a dot. It is T in tot, or it gives T, T sound. T. Then Yod.
Yod.
Yod is a smallest alphabet out of this 22 alphabet. Although it was not in the Phoenician language, it was the complete arm. It represents the complete arm. But in the process of time, as the language was developed, the Yod became very small alphabet as they borrowed the Aramaic script. And now it is a Jewish script. So this Yod is a very small alphabet. Like Yeshua, Jesus says, a small dot or jot. So it is Yod is like a small jot. Yod gives Y sound in yes, or you can say y. Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah.
Then calf with dot, that is calf. Calf. Calf in kit. So it gives K sound. And without dagesh, actually in English transliteration, there is no differentiation between sound, but there is a little differentiation. It gives like a khet sound, k, k. And that kap sofit comes at the end of the word, it gives k, k sound. That the sound is very similar to khet. For example, simcha. Simcha. So that final letter is Khet. Then Malek. Malek. That final letter, is Kap Sofit. So that Kap gives sometimes, not sometimes, but when it comes at the end of the word, that Kap Sofit, it gives a K sound. K.
Kap.
Then Lamed.
Lamed.
English transliteration is L, L in lot.
L.
L. And about Lamed, it is the biggest alphabet. It is the biggest alphabet. So can you tell me now which is the smallest and which is the biggest alphabet?
Smallest is Yod. Biggest is Lamed.
Very good. Next is Mem.
Mem.
Mem gives M sound in mat, or it actually its sound is m.
Mat. Ma.
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 Then
noon.
N in not, and it gives n.
No.
Sound. Then Samik, it is clearly S. S in
sat. Samik. Sat.
Sat.
Samik.
It gives
Sir.
Sir. Sound. Actually, there are too many sibilants in this Hebrew alphabet. You will find so many S sounds. Sir. So, for example, Sade also gives a Sir sound. Then Zain, it also, though it is TS, but it gives S sound. And then next is Sain, Zain, Sare, and Samik. All these alphabets are called sibilant. And if you're learning modern Hebrew alphabet and its sound and its transliteration, be very careful, because this Tau, last alphabet Tau, as in classical biblical Hebrew, it gives T sound, but in modern Hebrew, there is another S sound it gives. When it comes at the end, it gives S sound.
Yes.
So be very careful. Tau gives actually T sound, not S sound. Then Ein. Ein is a silent letter. It is a reverse apostrophe English transliteration is reverse apostrophe. And please remember it, that although it is a silent letter in ancient Phoenician language, it was not a silent letter. It is very hard to pronounce. When you pronounce ein, the two gutters come very close, and when that air has to come out of the gutter, so it is very hard to distinguish. So that's why in ancient time that name Gomorrah, it is the first alphabet uses ein. So ein, although it is a weak guttural, it is a guttural letter actually, and it gives a guttural sound G. Sometimes it gives guttural sound G. So it's actually pronunciation is Gomorrah. Gomorrah.
Gomorrah.
Gomorrah. Like Arabic ghain, there is a different letter for that G. But ein is actually silent letter. And whichever vowel we had put under it, it will take that sound.
Okay.
Next is pay and fay. Pay and fay. Clear P is with dagesh. It is clear P in pat. And without dagesh is F in fat or PH in phone. PH in phone. So with dagesh, it will give P sound. P.
So without dagesh.
With dagesh, it will give P sound. P. And without dagesh, that is a red color one, it will give F. F sound. Then sade. Sade is also called a sibilant, and it also gives a yes sound. For example, I will give you example. Yahweh Sevaot. Yahweh Sevaot, Lord of armies. So that Sevaot word, it gives clear, not very clear S sound. It is actually, though it is TS, and in English transliteration, they have made it TZ. Tazwaot, but it is not Tazwaot, it is Sevaot. So English transliteration is under S, there is dot, because Samek gives clear S sound. So it is like TS sound in bats. Then Kof. Kof. It gives Q sound. Q sound. And as we transliterate into English, you know that only Q. If we transliterate in English, it is K. For example, Kvadosh in Hebrew, if they transliterate, they will pronounce it in English, then they will say Kadosh. In some modern Hebrew song also, you will see Kadosh, but it is not actually clear K. For clear K, it is Kap is there. But for this Q, although in English, Q is transliterated, the sound is K, but in Biblical Hebrew, it gives a Q sound in queen. Q sound in queen. Or in Quran. Quran. The one word I will give you is Kadosh, that is holy. It is not Kadosh, no. Kadosh. Kol. Kol means voice. Kol Kore, the voice crying. Bemidbar, in the wilderness. So that is, in classical biblical Hebrew, it is Q sound, not K. and in we can transliterate it as quo. 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 Q and W. If you join it together, the sound will get quo.
Quo.
Not q. Quo. Qua. Yeah. Quadosh.
Quadosh.
Then R. 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 R sound in rot. Rot.
R.
R. Now, please observe very carefully. Till now, I have spoken about the four guttural letters. First one is Aleph. Second one is He. Third one is Khet. Fourth one is Ain. And next guttural letter is Resh. But it is not a technical one. It sometimes behaves like a guttural sound. So it is not technically guttural letter. So mark it very clearly. Write it down that Resh is sometimes it behaves as a guttural. Not always. But it is in the category of guttural. Then seen and sheen. Seen and sheen. Yes. Yes sound. Again here this another sibilant. This red color when dotted as left hand side, that is yes seen. Yes in seen. So sound. And above S in English transliteration is acute accent. And the shin, right side, when dot is at the right hand side, this over S, there is a circumflex, which is towards downward. So it is SH sound. Like sh.
Sure.
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 And the last alphabet is
Tau.
In English, we cannot distinguish between these two sounds, but in ancient Phoenician language, they have distinguished two sounds, and I can better give you that sound in Hindi only. T and th. So that is with dagesh, it is clear T. T. And without dagesh, the sound is in between T and TH. T and TH. Yes. That is th. Th. TH in theory. TH in theory. But if you are watching the modern Hebrew YouTube videos, be very careful. The another sibilant, another yes sound, this tau gives. When it comes, tau comes at the end of the word, they pronounce it as a yes sound. So how many yes sound we got? Anyone say?
Samek.
Zain.
Zain.
Then Samek.
Samek.
Then Sade.
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 Sade. Shin and Shin.
Shin and Shin.
Shin. And Shin. And
five.
Tau.
Tau is not, it is not giving yes sound, please.
Five, around five letters.
Around five letters, they give yes sound and they are called sibilant. Hmm?
Five.
That's yes, yes sound it gives. So,
yes.
Hmm?
So. Zion, Samik, Sade, Sin and Shin.
Yeah. Sin and Shin are one alphabet. One alphabet. Hmm? In ancient Phoenician language, because there is a distinguishing sound between s and sh. S, sh. So that's why this they put the dot at left hand side, it is s. Dot at the right hand side, it is sh.
Yeah. So these are called as sibling.
Sibilant. Sibilant. It is giving S sound. S, s sound. S.
Yes. Sibilant.
Yeah. Yeah. This teeth, teeth is called dental. It is a, it gives a dental sound. Then this beth, mem, and pe, they are called labials because they are called the letter of the lips. So don't worry now. We are going to take each of that category in next or next to next session. So only remember now that there are five guttural letter. They are aleph. Repeat after me. Aleph.
Aleph.
Hey. Hey.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey.
Ket.
Ein.
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 And which is the sometimes guttural?
Resh.
Resh.
Resh
is the sometimes guttural letter. Then there are three letters which are called labials. Which are they? Beth. Pronounce it and you will see your lips are moving. Beth.
Beth. Beth.
Mem.
Beth. Mem.
Mem.
Pain.
Pain. Pain.
Pain.
Pain. Can you repeat?
Pain.
Mem.
Beth. Mem. And pain.
Pain.
Pain. So these are what?
Label.
Label. Label.
Label.
Label. Label. Label. Letter label. Of the lips.
Label. Achha.
Label. Label.
Label.
Label. How do you spell label? It's
I-A-L-A-B-I-A.
There is given in chat box. Hein? Label.
Okay.
Okay, see, last time I have shown you how to write all these alphabet. Once again, that slide I am showing you before. In Aleph, if you are writing Aleph, then there is one diagonal and there is little gap here. And it will cover the whole box. Whole box. While writing Beth, the at the down there is a ledge. Ledge. Upside there is no ledge, only down, and it will also cover the whole box. Whereas Gimel, it covers only the right corner. Right corner. Make sure that there is a foot. Then for Dalet also, upside there is a upper top, there is a ledge. Then please observe that for Hay, there is a broken portion. There is a broken portion. For Wow, it will take one corner. One corner. Then please observe Zain also takes one right corner. Khet will cover whole box. Teth also will cover whole box. Yod will take only one upper corner. Then for Kaf, this portion is rounded. Please. This portion is rounded. Some if you write it like a flat line, then it is like a beth. So this portion is rounded. Then for dalet, sorry, for kaf sofit, the line goes below the box. And you have to give this ledge. Then Lamed, the line goes above the box. Then mem it covers the whole box. Mem sofit also it covers the whole box. Make sure that it is not like a samik. It is not rounded portion. It is like a rectangular, or it is 90 degree angle. This both side. Noon covers only one side of the box. Noon sofit, it goes below the line. Samik, it is complete round, and this ledge you have to show. Then ayin also covers like this. Pe also covers the whole box. Pe sofit line goes below the box. Sare, please observe. Sare sofit line goes below the box. Kof. Kof also, this is, although it is a consonant, it, line goes below the box. It is not a final form, but line goes below the box. Resh, then sin and sheen, and tau. The difference between khat and tau, please observe this angle. Okay. Next time for 10 minutes, we'll take the recognition. We'll see how to recognize the alphabet. Okay. Now tell me, which is this?
Yod.
Pardon?
Can you show the first three? How you show the letters? Yeah,
please. You're taken?
So the lower part can return one more time?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Now tell me, which is this alphabet?
Yod.
Yod.
Yod. Yes.
This one?
Nun sofit.
This is non nun sofit. It is wow.
Wow. Yeah.
Road. This is nun
sofit.
Nun sofit.
And this one.
Wow.
Zain. Yes.
So these alphabets are very confusing. Now these three, if you see. These three alphabet. So waw, nun sofit, and zain. So they looks very similar, but what is difference between them? You please observe. This waw comes, it does not go below the box.
Below the, yeah.
Nun sofit goes below the box, whereas zain, if you see, there is a tilted portion or at the top. And also one more confusing alphabet is, which is this?
Alef.
Kaf sofit.
Oh.
Because these two alphabets are very confusing. Kaf sofit and sofit. Okay. So next time we'll take 10-15 minutes revision on recognition of this alphabet. We'll recognize this alphabet. Now, tell me.
Bet.
And this one.
Cup.
So please observe that this portion and this portion, this is curvy, and this portion, you please observe it. Very confusing.
So it sounds like half. P H.
Too much noise.
Much of noise.
Okay, for 5 minutes, I will put all of you on mute, and I think it is enough. Otherwise, it will be too much for you. Next time, I request all of you, those who have practiced 5 times, praise God for them. You have done the excellent work. Next time, again, this week, practice the alphabets. As I told you, that alphabets are the building block. If you know the alphabets and their sound, and its English transliteration, then it will be for you, very easy for you for understanding the next chapters. So just for 5 to 7 minutes, we are going to see the application part, why we are learning this, so that we may apply it for our personal growth. So last time we have seen the beautiful petition, or the tefilla, that is prayer, that's God's Abed, that is servant Moses, is praying to God. Although he had seen him 40 days and 40 nights, continuously he was beholding his beautiful face. Please excuse me, there was connectivity issues. Okay, am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, yes, I can hear you.
Okay, so last time we were seeing about this, the petition of God's servant Moses, and he is praying unto God, and here Yahweh said to Moses, I will do this thing also that you have spoken, for I have found favor in thy sight, and I know you by name. Here God is saying to his servant Moses that I know you by name. And next, he gives us a petition in Exodus 33 verse 18. Vayomer hareini na it kevodeka. Now we know that in Mount Sinai he had seen God's face continuously 40 days and 40 nights, but here he's making again petition that shows his spiritual maturity, and that shows that how he's hungry and thirsty for God, and he's praying unto God. Vayomer hareini na it kevodeka. So without unmuting yourself, you can say Vayomer hareini na it kevodeka. Mujhe apna tej dikha de. And he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. Show me thy glory. Now God's servant Moses, when he's praying that Yahweh Elohim, please show me your glory, he's actually saying that please show me the glory of your heaviness, your riches, your glory, your splendor, and please show, because you are distinct and you are God who is greatly to be praised, honored. And here God's servant Moses is asking God ki mujhe apni jadta dhani shandar vaibhav vishisht alag tu jo hai tera sanman dikha. And this prayer, when he's praying unto Yahweh Elohim, first thing, he will show his glory. He will show his kavod. The way he shows his kavod unto his servant Moses, he will pass all his goodness. This is the one of the way of God who is showing his glory to his servant Moses. When we also pray like this prayer of God's servant Moses, please, ra'ini it kevodeka. When we pray unto God, please show me your glory, first thing without asking, Yahweh Elohim will do for you is he will make all his goodness to pass before you. Yahweh Parmeshwar apni sari bhalai tumhe dikhayenga. Hindi mein likha hai dikhayega, but in English or in Hebrew, he says, I will pass before you. I will make that to overcome, that goodness to pass before you. And you will see around you, every side around you, that goodness of God, Yahweh Elohim, around you. When you ask this prayer, Lord, please show me your glory. Hareini na it kevodeka. When you ask this petition, first thing he will do for you, that he will pass all his goodness. And this is the one of the way which God shows to his servant. This is my way. When you ask for my glory, I will pass first my all goodness over you. And I promise you that if at the beginning, if you are saying Lora, not bad, that will be turned into Tomeud, because when we are in his presence, there is a fullness of joy. There is a fullness of his goodness. We all experience his goodness. And therefore, God's servant David, he says, test and see that Yahweh is good. Main tere sanmukh hokar chalte hue apni sari bhalai kya karunga? Dikhaunga. I will make all my goodness pass before you, and will proclaim the name of Yahweh before you. And he will proclaim again the name Yahweh, that is Iye Asher Iye. That is, he will prove in your life who he is. And another word, translation of the word Haya, means he exists. And because he's an alive God, he exists, he will give you also an existence. Your dead things will become alive. and all the dead area in your life, there will be springing up of life in that area, and there will be resurrection and life, because Yeshua is the resurrection and life, and he will make all his goodness pass before you, and he will prove his name to you, that and he will show that his name is Yahweh. He will proclaim his name Yahweh before you. And in Exodus 33:20-21, we see that, and he said, thou can't see my face. Face means faneka. For there shall no man see me and live. And the Lord said, behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. Now here, God is giving another level of his kavod to his servant Moses. And he's saying, there is another place. There is a place, makom means place. Makom iti ve nitsavta. Al Hatsur. Sur means rock. Sur means chattan. So God is telling Moses that no man, if they see my face, they will not live, because his face is so glorious. So no man can see, behold his face. And he's saying that there is a place, makom iti ve nitsavta al Hatsur. There is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. And we know in 22 and 23, and it shall come to pass while my glory passeth by, that I will put thee in the clift of the rock, and will cover thee with my hand while I pass by. Then I will make away my, I will take away my hand, and you shall see my back, but my face shall not be seen. Here in Hebrew it says, avor keodi ve shamtika ve nikrat hatsur. And he's saying that it shall come to pass while my glory passeth by. Now in Old Testament, God's servant Moses, he's seeing that glory which is passeth by. And now we are in that generation, we are in that age where God want to show us that fullness of his kavod. Or jab tak mera tej tere samne se hoke chalta hai, tab tak main tujhe chattan ki darar mein rokunga, aur jab tak main tere samne se hokar na nikal jau, tab tak apne haath tujhe dhape rahunga, phir main apna haath utha lunga, tab tu mere peeth ko darshan payega, not face, mera tej jo muh ke wo nahi dekh payega. So here God's servant Moses, God is showing him the passing glory. And the rock which is speaking about, who is that rock? Chattan kon hai? In 1 Corinthians 10:4, it says, and all drank the same spiritual drink, for they long drank the water from that flowed from the spiritual rock that went with them, and that rock was Christ, Christos. In Greek it is called Christos. Chattan to Masih tha. And God has shown him the passing glory, the glory which is passing. And he has hidden him the clift of the rock. And actually that rock was Christ. In 1 Corinthians 10:4 says that rock was Christ. Now, who is Yahweh's glory or kavod? Yahweh Eloheka gauro kon hai? In Hebrew 1:3, it is written in CEV translation, God's son has all the brightness of God's own glory. Uski mahima ka prakash aur uske tatva ki chhaap hai. Yeshua is God's son and has all the brightness of God's own glory. Yeshua is that God's kavod, Yahweh's kavod or Yahweh's glory is Yeshua. And if we believe in Yeshua, our transformation, we will be transformed from one level of Yahweh's kavod to another level. I will not read all this, but we know that whatever Moses had seen, it was a fading glory or it was a passing glory. And it is written, you can read at home, 2 Corinthians 3, 7 to 18, only 18th verse I will read. And we all, with unveiled face, beholding the glory of Yahweh and being transformed into the same image from one degree of kavod to another. For this comes from Yahweh, who is Ruach, that is spirit. Yahweh, who is the spirit. And we are so privileged, we are so blessed that we are at this age or generation that we are seeing the full glory, which transforms us from one level of kavod to another level of kavod. If we are having ish, that is the fire of God, that glory will turn to you into the ish lohet, that is flames of fire. It will make you the flames of fire. It will take you into the spiritual realm from one level of kavod to the another level of kavod. And your every area of your life, there will be transformation, there will be turnaround, there will be a kavod, the jarta, that is the heaviness will come upon your life. In every area of your life, in your social life, in your financial life, in every area of your life, there will be turnaround. There will be changing from one degree of glory to another degree of glory, because what God's servant Moses was saying, that was the fading glory. It was the ministry of condemnation. It was the ministry of death. But the Yeshua is the life and resurrection. He is giving us the ministry of reconciliation. He is giving the ministry of resurrection. He is giving the ministry of Kaim, that is life. The ministry of Zoe, that is life. Because the old is passing away, but the new, the veil that was upon the Moses' face, it has been removed, and that veil, it turns to Yahweh. That veil is removed in Christ Yeshua. And now 17th verse says, now Lord, that is Yeshua, is a spirit. And where the spirit of the Lord Yeshua is, there is a freedom. And we all with unveiled face beholding the glory, that is kavod of Yahweh, Yeshua, and are being transformed into the same image from one degree of kavod to another. And this comes from the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, who is Ruach. May Yahweh Elohim make his face shine upon you. Yahweh Elohim apna mukh prakash hum par banaye rakhe. Thank you. God bless you. Okay. We'll end the session. Anyone who is led by the Spirit, they can end the session with prayer. You can unmute and pray the last prayer. Can you unmute yourself? Okay. You can unmute yourself now.
Let me pray. Gracious and loving Father in heaven, we thank you for this wonderful time. We thank you for this wonderful session of Hebrew learning by Rahul sir. Thank you for the glory bestowed upon him, Lord. Thank you for the willingness and humbleness given to him, Lord. Thank you for all the participants. Thank you for whatever we have learned today, Lord. Lord, by learning Hebrew, let us understand your word in a very nice manner, in a very good manner, Lord. and to apply it in our lives. Lord bless each one of the participants, and especially Brother Rahul and his family, Lord. Lord, we all humble down before your gracious throne, Lord. Help us, Lord. Bless us, Lord. All we ask in the mighty and matchless name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. 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 Thank you, brother. Thank you. Toda, thank you.
Thank you.
God bless
brother.
You all.
Thank
Yahweh,
you.
Evarekeka. That means God bless
thank you. Sir.
Thank you. God bless you.
God bless you too, sir.
God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you, Baba.